Hey guys, so today we are going to talk about how to drink wines at home. The question always is that, you know, what temperature should I drink at? What are the tools that I need to drink wine at home? So many questions. I'm going to try to answer all of them today in a combination. So what I have in terms of tools at home is very simple. I've got wine glasses, simple wine glasses. You can have fancy ones. Which is this one, which is a Swissel handmade series, and something which is very simple. I have a corkscrew, very very important to have, a very simple if you see a tool. But the most important thing in this is that it has got two steps, and I'll show you why, which is used to open a bottle with a cork. And Coravin, which is very important if you want to drink only one glass from a bottle, if you don't want to open a bottle of wine. What we are going to do is, if you come here, I'll show you, we're going to open four different wines, which has got four different closures. So the first very classic one is the cork one, which we have, and the wine is from Portugal called Cabriz. The second is a white wine with a screw cap, which is one of the most easiest to open. The third one looks like the one with the cork, but actually it has got a glass stopper and it's also very easy to open. And then the fourth one is a sparkling wine. This we are opening a Cava from Gramona, which is from Spain. So what I have done is, right now most of the people don't have wine fridges at home, and they keep their wines lying around, and then they want to drink the bottle of wine, and they always ask at what is the right temperature to drink at. So we are going to do the simple exercise. We're going to take all four wines and we're going to put it in the fridge. So follow me. Okay. So I'm going to put all these four wines in the fridge right now, and we're going to take them out at the right time. 6:30 right now, and we have kept all the four wines in the fridge. The first wine that we're going to pull out is a red wine, because the red wine needs to be chilled up to 16 degrees Celsius. So I'm going to record the time that it is going to reach that temperature, so you know exactly at what time it comes out, and then followed by white wine, and then followed by champagne. Okay guys, so it's 8:15 right now, and we have put the wines into the fridge at around 6:30. So we are opening, just checking the temperature, and this red wine is at the perfect temperature to drink, and I would say something around 16 degrees Celsius. So for it to become 16 degrees Celsius, it takes 1 hour and 45 minutes. Okay, so let's go and open this wine right now. If you noticed, I haven't taken out the white wines, the rosé wines, as well as the champagne, or the cava actually, because the temperature of these wines are not yet correct. But for the reds, it's perfect. Okay, two ways that we can open this bottle of wine. One is, if you want to drink this entire bottle by itself, and then, you know, you can open the cork of the wine through this corkscrew. Or there is another interesting way to open this bottle of wine, if you have something called as Coravin. This is one of the most exciting techs that have come out in the wine world. It is an American company, and if you are a single diner and you want to extract a glass of wine by keeping the bottle closed and drink it, then actually you can use it. It's available on Amazon for around in between around 20 to 25 thousand. So this is how you use it. It's got this surgical needle, if you see, and this is the bottle. You put it on top without opening the foil, without taking out the cork, and first you give it a whiff, and then you insert this needle inside the cork. So So the bottle is closed, the needle is gone in. You push the argon gas inside and the wine comes out. Okay, it's displacement theory. Again, you push the argon gas and the wine comes out. Yeah. Enough. You can take out as much wine as you want. Pull out the needle. Voila. See? No leakage, nothing. You have extracted a small glass out of the wine without opening the bottle of wine, and this bottle goes into the fridge again, and you have a perfectly nice glass of wine to drink. We are drinking a wine from Portugal called Quinta de Cabris. Most of the people know Portuguese wines to be port wines, sweet wines, but actually they make some amazing kick-ass wines which are reds and whites. This particular one comes from the region of Dao, and the grape varietal is a blend of three. One is Touriga Nacional, which is their indigenous grape varietals. In fact, all of three are indigenous. The other one is called Alforesio, and the third one is called Argonés. So these are the three grapes that we are drinking. It's 2017. It's nice, fruity, well balanced, good acidity. At the same time, it's got good body, because if you consider Portugal, it is in the south, and you know the temperature of Portugal is quite warm, and so they are known to make a little bit of a heavier bodied wine. Now, if you are not a single diner and you don't have this tech called Coravin, then you need to open this bottle of wine. And as I said, we need a nice corkscrew. So all the good corkscrew comes with a knife, which is at the back. And what you do with the knife is you cut the foil. A lot of times people cut the foil out here, which is actually wrong. You have to cut the foil underneath like this. All you do is move the knife around completely so the foil is cut. Give it a nice clean cut here, and the foil comes out very easily. Just like that. The trick is to put the corkscrew right in the middle and then just go all the way down. All the way. And then a good corkscrew always has got something called a push, where you have your first one coming up and then the second lever where you have the second one coming. So it's very easy to pull it out. Really no rocket science here. And the bottle is open, pour a little bit for yourself. And I always say that as soon as you pour things, put back the cork in like this and then put it back in the fridge. By doing this, you are limiting the oxygen which is getting exposed to the wine, and at the same time you're putting it back into the fridge so that the temperature is cool enough for it not to spoil the wine. By doing that, you can actually drink this wine for the next 3 to 4 days without the wine being spoiled. So a lot of people ask me questions, you know, why are you not bringing 375 ml bottles so that, you know, it's a single diner use, you know, we can drink it without spoilages. Well, the fact is that a lot of producers that we import into India don't make 375 ml. A lot of good producers actually don't make 375 ml. And the ones they do, the cost of 375 ml is so much more higher that that people, once they come into the market, don't want to buy it. So this is a great, great way to preserve a good bottle of. So it's 9:30, we had kept the wines in the fridge at around 6:30, so it's 3 hours now, and we're going to take out a bottle of rosé and a bottle of white wine to try. This is at a perfect temperature of, I would say, around 10 degrees Celsius, and remember one thing, if you guys want to drink a nice bottle of white, it has to be in the fridge for 3 hours. A nice bottle of rosé, it has to be in the fridge for 3 hours. And a good bottle of red, then around, you know, 1 hour and 45 minutes. So now, the second closure that we are going to open is the screw cap. This is the most easiest closure to open. It does not require any instruments like the corkscrew or even Coravin. All you have to do is to twist it, and this is what I'm doing. I just twist the cap, open it, and just pour it and twist it back on. And important again, twist it back on again and then put it back into the fridge so the wines are refreshing. What we are drinking here, we are drinking a 2019, this is a new wine edition, Torrentes from Susanna Balbao. Wow, this wine is beautiful. It has got this smells of lychee. If you know what lychees are, you know, it also resembles a little bit of roses, but lychee is what you really smell of. Good minerality, nice lychees. Super crisp, not sweet, gold dry, and lychees all the way. I think if you enjoy aromatic style wines, I think there's no better wine to drink than Torrentes. This is run by Susanna Balbao, the winery. She's the first woman winemaker in Argentina, started in 1981. And she is known as the Queen of Torrentes. So she kind of brought back this grape to life. So very exciting wine. I think one of my favorites in our entire portfolio. So this is going to go back in the fridge. Now we are going to open a rosé. Pretty much the same temperature that you want to do it at around 10 degrees Celsius to keep it in the fridge for 3 hours. But this is a different closure. So what you do is, it's a glass topper. It comes like a cork. It comes in a foil. You open the foil like how you open the glass topper, and then take the foil off, and then you come across something like this, which is basically a glass topper. And all you have to do is to pop this open. This is a brand new technology. This is which has come up in the early 2000s, and it's a German technology. And this is a rosé that we are drinking. You see the color; it's a beautiful color, very light in style, very Provence style rosé. And the wine is called Skaya. It comes from Italy. From the region of Veneto, and from a producer called Tenuta Sendento. But again, coming back to the glass topper, if you guys have never seen it, if you see something like this, then it's a glass topper, and then you just pop it open, and then you pop it back on. And the beauty of this bottle is that once you finish the bottle, you can actually remove these labels and use it as a bottle for water. Okay. We are trying this rosé. The grape variety on this is called Rondinella. It's actually a red grape. Most of the rosés are made from red grape varietals. And it's a very light, very fragrant in style. It's got aromas of red fruit, sweet red fruit. Very floral, actually. Very elegant. Very fruity. Beautiful acidity. Very refreshing. It's almost like you're drinking a white wine, you know.
you don't really feel as if, you know, it comes from a red grape. It's a very, but it, because it comes from a red grape, it's got a little bit of body to it, but extremely fragrant just because of the red grape. So it's got this beautiful combination that you're drinking a white wine, but it feels the body is that of a red wine. So it's very fragrant, you know, very fruit forward, but great acidity, very crisp, very nice finish. And rosés are definitely one of the most rocking things that are happening today in the world. And if you guys have never tried a rosé, then you have to pick a bottle up and drink it. You close this and it goes back into the fridge. These wines, actually, if you close it at the right time, you can drink it over a week and it is not going to deteriorate in the quality and the style. But you just have to make sure that when you open it, you close it quickly and you have minimal oxygen contact. Now for the final wine, and we're going to bring out our best glass of the house, which is actually a Schott Riesel from the hand blown collection. We are at 10:30 in the evening, and so we have kept this wine into the fridge at around 6:30, so it's 4 hours already, and the wine is nice and chilled. Very, very important that if you're opening a sparkling wine, the temperature has to be right. You have to try to drink this wine at around 6 to 8 degrees Celsius, so you know it tastes nice and super crisp. We're going to drink it in our Schott Riesel glass, which is hand blown and super expensive. But hey, you only live once. Okay, so we just opened, just to show you the way we are opening it. We just, every sparkling wine has a foil and it has got an edge where you can actually tear it and it goes all the way around. So this is what I've done. We just tore it. And it's very, very important when you open a sparkling wine is to keep the cork away from everybody else, including yourself, because there are lots of accidents that happen which you can actually pop it into your face and you can get seriously hurt. So what I'm trying to do is facing it towards the wall. I'm gonna have my thumb on top of it, wrap it around and open this wire cage which holds the cork securely. The way to do it is, now that the wire cage is open, you just turn the bottle from below and pop it. Beautiful. And when this happens, it's just amazing. You are pouring into a glass, beautiful bubbles. This is Gramona. It's a cava from 2013. Cavas actually have a very bad reputation, because you know, as compared to a champagne, because you know either they are produced in mass produced style and so on and so forth. But here we are talking about Gramona. It's one of the premier cava producing estates. In fact, they only make Gran Reserva, which means that the wines are aged in the bottle for minimum of 3 years before release, almost like a champagne. And they are 100% organic and biodynamic, by the way. And what is biodynamic is a topic for another IGTV line. But we are drinking this wine in a Schott Riesel champagne glass. If you see, it's not a flute, but actually it is it's a glass with which is like a white wine and then opens up in the top. So today most of the people in champagne or sparkling wines are reinventing how you have to drink a sparkling. It should not be drunk in a flute, because this is a wine and you need to smell the wine. If it's a flute, you'll not be able to smell the wine. You'll only be able to see the bubbles. And bubbles is just one part of the sparkling. But the most important thing about a sparkling is the nose. Okay? Because it's a wine. And this has got just the most amazing nose. If the wines are aged for 3 years in a bottle, the one of the noses that you get is like a bakery. You know, it's like a bread, like a toast. And it's one of the most appealing noses in a sparkling wine. It's bready, it's toasty, it's yeasty. And these are the characteristics where people really look for when you're drinking a very high quality sparkling wine. And this is what I'm getting. Beautiful. Beautiful acidity. The grape which is used for the sparkling is called Xarello and Macabeo. It's indigenous grape varietals for Spain from the Penedès region. And I love this one. I mean, I got Gramona into India because I thought that there is no wine that I tasted which is comes as close to champagne or even better than champagne than Gramona. I think it's one of my favorite sparkling wines in the world. I absolutely love it. One of the ways that you can preserve a good sparkling wine, if you want to finish the bottle, if you don't want to finish the bottle, is by putting a stopper into it. And just hold on. This is the stopper. The stopper is actually a Bellicat Sauvignon, but you're gonna put it in and we're gonna close it. So next time you wanna get a sparkling wine and you don't wanna finish it, then always ask the guys whom you're buying it from for a nice stopper. Okay? And we can get that for you. So this is a great stopper. This goes in, it preserves the sparkles, it preserves the wine. And you can drink this tomorrow with the same fizz that you wanted. So that's it. You can drink great quality bottles of wine, white wines, red wines, rosé wines and sparkling at home. Preserve it so that you can drink it for the next 1 week without deteriorating in quality. Okay. And enjoy it. And you don't have to really worry about buying that 375 ml bottles of wine all the time. If you guys want to buy these wines, you know where to go. It's called thewinepark.com. And have a great week. Cheers.